according to Buddhism and the believer and tradition, when you read sutra and all that, you have to put on incense, flower, you know, and bow to the sutra first and thank all the Buddhas and Bodhisattva in 10 directions, all respectfully, before you read it, okay? And then you cover the sutra also with silk, you know, beautiful cloth, and I just make it more popular. Yeah, more easy, simple. And I apologize to all the Buddha. I say, if I done something wrong, according to the tradition, my heart is full of respect. It's just that I cannot always do that. So please, all the sin, whatever I've done wrong, is all on me. At least other people, they hear the names of the Buddha, according to the sutta, they will get benefit. Yes.
Hello.
Hello.
Your mama is here. Yeah. Yeah. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Okay. Very good. Welcome, all of you. Chinese, Taiwanese, or whateverese you are. Denise. Hmm? Hey, you are here? Ah, welcome. I have to check out my spiritual weapons. Huh? Yeah, perfect. Chi. Miracle. You didn't know I know a miracle, did you? Okay. Today I saw some good news on TV, huh? News. That there is a place named Charan in Mexico. The village people, they protect their forest. Before there was some people who went there and you know, deforested to sell the logs or something. And they protect them. They try to protect them. And they even lost their lives. Some lost their lives because of protection. I think we should donate something to them if you can find it. Huh? If you tell FG can find out where that village is and give them some donation. Give them like $20,000, shall we? Can you tell them that? Ooh. $20,000 if they can find the village called Charan. C-H-E-R-A-N. C-H-E-R-A-N. Charan. In Mexico, yeah? Got it? They're protecting their forest by themselves, you know, before some people with armed guard and all that. They even lost their lives protecting it. And now they're even planting new trees to replace the one that they cut down. And tell FG to give them a leadership award, huh? Environmental Protection Leadership Award. Okay, huh? If you can, huh? Thank you. If they can find out. All right, now I'm done with all this job. Now I take care of you, huh? Some men can also sit in front of there, or some woman can sit in front of there until I'm going out. Yeah, okay? Yeah. One sit there. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, just block the road, don't matter. Yeah, until I go out, okay? Okay, then. Now we're cozy, huh? Everybody okay then?
Yes.
Yeah, woman can sit on the road there, I don't mind, okay? I can walk on your shoulders. Yeah, big shoulders, yeah. Whew. Okay, at least our world is okay, yeah? Even the world around us is not all okay. I found one story I haven't told you. You want to hear it?
Yes.
Yes, of course, oh, I found it. It's about Shakyamuni Buddha when he, you know, former life, as usual. Mm? Are you all right? Jet lag? If you want to sleep, just fine. I don't care. They do it all the time. Because this story is about the Buddha's, one of his former life, that he sacrificed even his own body part. Not just hands, foot, or flesh, but his own head. Just so that he will become Buddha. Yeah, so many sacrifices he has to go through to earn enough merit to reclaim his Buddhahood again. As I told you already, he has been Buddha a long, long time ago. But in order to show affinity with new sentient beings or older sentient beings, which he has not delivered in some former life, has affinity with him, he has to come back again and start from zero. Okay, now, but if you sacrifice something of your body, maybe, I don't know, maybe you also... Possible, some Buddhas around here? Huh? Camera, this way. Check out if any Buddhas is hanging around here. Do they look any more? Maybe that's one without hair look like. Okay, that one also no hair, maybe, huh? And this one with a cap with no hair inside. Oh! Because this camera cannot reach them, so sometimes you know, turn around to show the Buddha's face. And there's another one here and another one there, no hair. The ones that the hair fall off doesn't count, okay? Okay. All right then, everybody settle down?
Yes.
Happy?
Yes.
Translation okay?
Yes.
Good. Okay. Thus I have heard, one time the Buddha was in the country called Tisali, in another forest called Ala. At that time, the world honored one asked me, thus, me mean who? Anna, just you know everything. Incredible. How? How could you guess? At least you remember one name, huh? Okay. So I didn't waste too much of my time. I thought I was talking to the sleeping ears. But I was wrong. All right. Okay. So the world honor one mean the Buddha asked Anand thus. Oh man, this is a sad story. Double sad. I'm warning you, okay? If you don't want to hear it, just do Guan Yin. Whoever attained the four miracles, special miracles, yeah, then they will be able to live one aeon. But now I already attained this four miracle, but even also plus, you know, mean plus that I'm still practicing, yeah, meaning even more, yeah, more merit. So do you think, how long will I, do you know how long I will live? How long is my longevity? The Buddha asked Anand three times. And he asked himself. I said, at that time, maybe I was possessed by a demon or something, so I have not answered him. I kept quiet. And then the Buddha said to me, Anand, now you go to a quiet area and think about it. Yeah. So I obeyed the Buddha's command and went into a forest, the forest. After I left, the Maya came, the king of Maya came, and said to the Buddha, obeisance to the world honored one. You have been preaching in this world a long time already. Yeah. You have also saved a lot of sentient beings, as many as the sands of the Ganges River, meaning countless, yes. Now you already became older. Old. It's better you go to Nirvana, meaning leave the world, leave the physical body. Yeah. Okay. And then the Buddha took a little bit, you know, a pinch of sand and put it on his palm and asked the Maya king, this little sand on my hand here, is it a lot or a little? Yeah. So the Maya king say, the little sand on my hand is a lot, or the earth around on the planet is a lot. So the king of Maya say, sir, the sand on the planet, you know, is a lot, of course, more than the sand in your hand. And then the Buddha said, the beings that I ferry across, liberated, are as little as that little sand on my hand only. And then the beings that has not been liberated are as much as the earth on this planet, as much as the sand on this planet. Okay, but never mind. 3 months later, I will enter Nirvana. Oh, the king of Maya heard the Buddha say that. He was so happy. How can? Joyfully. And then he bowed to him and left. How can that be? He's truly Maya. I was sitting in the forest, Anan. Yeah. I was sitting in the forest and I was kind of dozing off. Yeah, typical. I saw a lot. It's so familiar. I was dozing off and then I dreamed that a big, big, great giant tree that covered the whole sky, and the leaves is very lushful, green, and a lot of flowers and fruit on that tree. The merit of this tree is wondrous. Nobody can even describe it. And suddenly, out of nowhere, there was a big typhoon that came and then beat up that tree, so everything fell off, the leaves, the fruits, the flowers. I was so scared, and I was startled and awakened from the dream. My heart was still pounding. Yeah. Anand, not mine. Yeah. I wasn't there. Yeah. So I was thinking to myself, I was dreaming of this giant tree. It seems like such a tree that all the beings under the sun can profit, because it's so giant, so big. And suddenly, has no reason, as the wind came and beat it up, you know, like, how do you say? Tăng nát cái gì hả? Tăng nát tiếng Anh nói gì hiểu không? No. Beat it up severely, you know, like black and blue if it's a human. Yeah. It is likened to the world-honored one, the Buddha, that he saved, you know, the whole world from heaven to earth. Yeah. From mortal to sages, he saved them. Everyone, all beings, are receiving his blessing and grace as much, you know, as compared to this tree like that. So the dream, my dream, probably indicate that the Buddha is going to enter Nirvana soon. So I stood up and went into the ashram. I prostrated in front of the Buddha and said to him, "Obeisance to the world-honored one. Just now I have had a bad dream that a big giant tree that is protecting all beings on this planet, that cover the whole sky even, suddenly there's a big typhoon came and then broken that trees into nothing. Yeah, I guess, is it true, maybe that you are going to enter Nirvana? Is that correct, sir? Please tell me." So the Buddha told him, "Yes, it is true like that." 3 months later, I will enter Nirvana, as if I just told, as I have told you, that anyone who attain the 4 kind of special miracles, miraculous power, then they can live 1 aeon. Did I say that before? 1 aeon? Okay. And then I myself already attained this 4 wondrous miraculous power, and I still even continue to practice more. Yeah. And then I ask you, how long would you think I will live? I mean, mostly people, when they get these 4 miraculous power, and then they might stop doing anything. But he still continue. That means is even his merit even greater, yeah. And his longevity be more expansive. But I have asked you 3 times, and you never told me. You never answered me. After you left, the king of Maya came and invited me to enter Nirvana, and I have promised him already. After I heard the Buddha say thus, as if thunder have striked me, I was so sorrowful, so regretful. I was so sad, so sad. If now the Buddha is going to enter Nirvana, all beings has lost a place of refuge. Where will they go? Whom can they rely on? And after that, everybody else know. Other monks and nuns in the assembly knew about it. Everybody was so sad, so sad, so sad. And they are gathered around the Buddha and asking. And the Buddha said, "The whole world in this physical planet is all governed by the ephemeral law. The wheel of transmigration is always, turning. Yeah. Today you are here, tomorrow you may be gone. Yeah. No one, it's not predictable. No one can escape. It's not only human beings, but also animals, and even mountains, rivers, oceans, and even the universe. None will be able to sustain their existence forever. Because of all beings suffering, so I came here to this planet, and I think my job is done. Whatever I had to say, I already said. So all of you should be diligently practicing what I have taught you. Do not be so sad and sorrowful. It's useless. Yeah. And then Sariputra lamented. Thus, he lamenting, oh dear, you know, oh heaven, earth, and all that. The world's brightest eye is going to be gone. Eyes. The Buddha is likened to the eye of the world. Yeah. The thirst come one is going to enter nirvana. All beings has nowhere to rely on, nowhere to take refuge. After he said thus, he kneeled down in front of the Buddha, and then said to the Buddha, obeisance to the world honored one. I have no heart to see you going to enter nirvana, meaning to see you die. Yeah. Please allow me to go to nirvana first. Please be joyful and accept my request so that I feel satisfied. Yeah. He told the Buddha, he requested three times like that. Yeah. And the Buddha said, all right, yeah. You know, when the time is up, then even saints and sages will also leave the world. Yeah. After he heard the Buddha almost like, you know, accepting his request, he kneeled straight on his knees and circumambulated the Buddha 100 times on the knees, not on foot. Yeah. And then he came in front of the Buddha, held his feet and put it on top of his head three times. It's a utmost respectful sign what he has done, and like the last time ever. Yeah. And then he said to the Buddha, obeisance to the world honored one. Today is the last day I said farewell to you. And then he put his palm together with a respectful manner. He left. And then he went back to his country, you know, his birth country. And then one of the Sami, one of the young monk, went in to the official, to the royal court, and to report to the king. Yeah. And then others, relatives of Sariputra, so everybody came and said goodbye last time. And the king Asate, he's one of the very good follower, you know, of the Buddha. He knew that Sariputra reverence is going to enter nirvana. So he said to himself, the great reverend Sariputra is like a great general, you know, great general in Buddhism. Yeah. And now, oh God, he's going to enter nirvana. Why so soon? Why so early? Now we have no one to, how you say, to counter those negative beings. Yeah. After that, everyone, the king and the court officials, and all the others, relatives and citizen people, they all came. And they say, obeisance to reverence Sariputra. We have heard that you're going to enter nirvana. We feel as if we are the children who are losing the parents. As if the little chicks are losing the mother chicken. we are losing our refuge. We have nowhere to rely on, no one to rely on from now. And then Sariputra said to them, please, all the Buddhist follower, Buddha's follower, do not feel sad, do not feel sad. All the beings, anything at all on this planet belong to two words, that is ephemeral, one word, ephemeral. In Vietnam it's two words, yeah, ephemeral. unpredictable, you know? Yeah, all right. If something is born, that thing will be dead one day. In the three worlds, everything is full of suffering. None of us really have happiness and peace. In the former life, all of you have sowed a good deed, good seed. So today you have been fortunate to meet the Buddha in the world, living Buddha. Yeah, the Dharma is rare, difficult to listen to know. You all know. The human body is difficult to have. You all have, yeah. So you should use all this fortune to continue to practice diligently and sow good deeds, yeah. So that, and then I use this merit to transfer to your liberation, so that you will escape life and death forever. So, and continue like that. He preach according to each person's understanding and level of consciousness. Yeah. And he told them in such a skillful way, as if a doctor knowing what kind of disease each patient has and prescribe medicine accordingly. So they will recover quick, yeah. So after that, people, you know, many of them elevated their spiritual status, yeah, like from lower they go to middle and middle go higher, yeah, etc. And everyone is inspired toward, you know, the supreme attainment of Buddhahood, yeah. And then everybody feel more peaceful. They bow to him and left. At this time, it's already past midnight. So Sariputta sat very, quietly, and solemnly, yeah. And he paid all his attention to in front of him. You know where, yeah? That's what he say here. And then from the lower level of consciousness, he go to the second level of consciousness, and then third level, and then fourth level, and then to the higher, and then to Nirvana, yeah. You should know that every level of consciousness that I have told you, yeah, I have hundreds of sub-level, yeah? So it's not like, excuse me. Somebody give me this gift, huh? Who? I want to thank you, but who? No, it's not just one person. It's a mixture of karma. Yeah. Because I'm telling you, even in winter, I pass, you know, some winter without you. I never had a cold, even winter, colder. And I don't have much clothes, even just a blanket. Just simple like this, and then a blanket. sit outside, under the dews and sometimes wind and little rain and all that. I never had any cold. And here, I feel hot now. And I got a cold. Believe that? Okay. Yeah, that's the price. A small price. All right. Now he in Nirvana. He was in Nirvana already. One of the God from heaven, yeah. Maybe, I think he's a sacred God then, again. He's the one who makes trouble a lot. But he respects real practitioners. So he knew about all this. So he brought his relatives, so-called relatives in heaven, yeah. Retinue, his entourage. 100,000 people, more or less, and brought a lot of flowers and a nice incense, you know, from heaven down to make offering for last time. And he said, and he lamented, you know, reverence has such a great wisdom, as great as the sky, as great as the ocean. Your eloquence is always amazing, yeah, and quick-witted, yeah, as if, how you say, like blitz, yeah? Like blitz, right? No. Thunder? Blitz, huh? Right? Is that in English? Blitz? You know, like when
lightning.
Lightning, yeah, as fast as lightning. What is the word blitz?
It's in German, I think.
Oh, it's German, right? Okay, sorry about that. Because I watch television, it's all free of charge, those kind, you know? And most of them are German. So I got confused. I'm sorry. Yeah. I watch news in both, sometimes English and sometimes in German as well, because if I miss one channel for the news, and I'll switch it to German, understand? So that I know what's going on, yeah. Like some of the news I told you these days are from German channels as well as English channels, yeah? Because some channels have some different news, yeah, therefore I watch sometimes different channels, yeah. So as your eloquence is as fast as lightning, yes. And your voice is as beautiful as the brook, the sound of the stream. Your precepts, yeah, your samadhi power, your power of keeping precepts, your samadhi power, and your wisdom, all perfect. And you are the great general in Buddhism, representing the first come one to turn the wheel of Dharma. Now, dear heaven, oh, basically, dear heaven, dear God, something like that, you know, lamenting. Now, dear heaven, you are going to Nirvana, the world lost a bright eye, yeah. The world and heaven lost the bright eye. Now everybody, from the city to the suburb area, everyone brought flowers and incense and light. All went there to make offering to him. They say, oh, so crowded, you know, like the sea of people. Yeah. And then the sacred god and the other god and his assistant brought down the heavenly chariot to greet his coming. Yeah, to bring Sariputra to heaven. First, you know, slow, lower heaven, and then up, and then maybe other God will greet him up, and, you know, keep bringing up. Yeah. the chariot of Sariputta reverends went in the front, and after that there are heavenly beings and dragons, beings from the ocean, and even demons and ghosts, and then king, you know, this the worldly king and court officials, citizens, and they all went into a very flat but high but flat and very clean. And then the chakra god asked all of the demons to go out into the ocean on the beach, you know, where all the wood probably washed up ashore, yeah, and brought those like take wood, sandal wood, etc. And you brought it, bring it all over, bring from all over places, bring there to pile it up in one. Oh, this is still the physical body yet. I'm sorry. Yeah, I thought they bring the chariot from heaven, taking him up, but not yet. So they bring him, his physical, to that area with the pile of wood, and fragrant wood already piling up there. But he's already gone anyway. His soul already went to Nirvana. And this is only his physical body. They put it on top of the pile of wood, and then they burn the fire, yeah, so that his body will become cremated. Yes. Oh dear, I should stop watching German channel. The Vietnamese and German and English is lost. Yeah. I don't have any friends whom I speak English to, and I don't chat all day anyway, you know, I don't chat to anyone. So my tongue is kind of, you know, reluctant to come out again. I say, what? You have not been speaking all these days. Why are you talking now? The tongue has been on retreat for so long. I didn't want to work now. After they burned his body, everyone prostrated and went home. His assistant, no, his like attendant named Sami Kwande, he waited until the fire cooled down, and then he collect his sarira, the relic from Sariputta, and put it in his chasa, in the monk's robe, and brought it back to the Buddha, and said to the Buddha, obeisance to the world honor one, my Master Sariputra has already entered Nirvana. This is his sarira, his relic, and his habit, right? Habit? His monk's robe? You call it habit, right? Habit? No? Yeah, okay. And anyway, he's close. After I heard the Sami Kwande told the Buddha thus, I was so moved. I knelt down in front of the Buddha and said, "World Honor One, Sariputra Reverend Sariputra." Is a kind of a great general in Buddhism. Yeah. Why does he go to Nirvana so soon, so early? And now you are going soon. Whom are we going to be able to take refuge? So the Buddha said, the Buddha thought, even if Sariputra enter Nirvana, but his Dharma body and his precept and his samadhi power and his wisdom, his liberating power and his knowledge of liberating power has not entered nirvana. Because he doesn't have the heart to see me live in this world, therefore he enter nirvana first. Yes, that's the only reason. Yes, it's not the first time that he does this. Not only in this lifetime that he enter nirvana before me, but in a former life, he also cannot bear to see me go. I mean, you know, die. Therefore, he also died before me. Yeah. So Anand say, "Are you guys okay?
Yes.
Today we can't laugh too much, huh? Mm-hmm. Yes, I told you, I warned you that it's double sad. Yeah. Okay, but it's a long story. We can do it more tomorrow, the half, if you too sad or too tired. You okay?
Yeah.
You want to continue?
Yeah.
All right. Don't blame me if you cry. All right. So, Anand, continue. World honors one, obeisance to world honor one. They always say like that, very respectfully to the Buddha, always obeisance to the world honor one, or prostrate to the world honor one. Yeah, they don't say, "Buddha, what now?" You know, like, "Listen to me, Buddha," or "Answer me." And they don't do that, you know. Only we nowadays, we do this kind of thing. If Anand, you know, live until this time, or any of the Buddha's disciples or followers see us nowadays, they would just shake their head and say, "Okay, we all go to nirvana better." Not only Buddha no go nirvana, we all will. We go now together. Yeah. But I always said, even if people are rude to, you know, a saint or a practitioner of Zen or, you know, wisdom way or Buddha's way, even if they're rude, it's still better than they kill you, or they beat you up. So, yeah. Better than nothing. They still follow the same, even though they're rude. Yeah, I wonder myself, this kind of person, and he still follow me? Yeah, how? How can this kind of person still follow me and still believe in me? Understand me? Yeah, it's kind of miracle, amazing, amazing. Sometimes I look at some people and I say like that, the way they behave, their manner and all that, their manner of no manner, and I say, "Oh, this kind of person still follow me. Well, still better than nothing. It's still better than, you know, he not, okay?" Yeah. Now we always have to look at the sunshine side of the street, no? Okay. All right. So the Anand said to Anand, request the Buddha, obeisance to the world honored one. In the former life, how did Reverend Sariputra die before you, sir? Could you please be kind and tell us and the later generation so that we know? Yeah. All right, so Buddha said, "Anand, you should know, long time ago, also on this physical planet, same planet that we are in now, I wonder, long time ago, sometimes the Buddha said eons ago, it's the same world. That means our world exists longer than the scientists have told us. Yeah? They say just some 4 billion or something, huh? Or 4 million years. We exist before that. And then probably something happened, and many people die, or most people die, and then we started again. Yeah. Remember many stories? The Buddha say that aeons ago even, also on the same planet, this planet, I was doing so and so, I was doing such and such, and this person was doing such and such. Huh, remember?
Yes.
Yeah, that means our planets existed long, 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 long time ago. Yeah. Immeasurable time ago. All right. Also in this, on the same planet, yeah. There was a king named Chenda Balati. In Chinese is Moonlight. Yeah, Moonlight. The name, the king is Moonlight. Yeah. He is a great emperor. He ruled over 84,000 smaller country, you know, meaning a lot. Yeah, remember, always 84,000 ways of enlightenment, you know, of liberation, of Dharma, 84,000 smaller country, 84,000 concubine, whatever, and then 500 something, 500 this, 500 that. 6 million of mountains and rivers, 6 billion of smaller tribes, and he has 2 million. I'm lost. 2 million or two billion even. Wow, that's a lot. Could be trillion even. Wife and concubines. Yeah. The first wife name is flower. Okay, listen. I guess it's like this. I guess it's not like 2 billion or 2 trillion or even two million wives and concubines. I guess a lot of people follow him, you know, vow to be his wife, vow to be, worshipping him instead of marrying somebody else. You know, so many countries added together, so it's become 2 billion or 2 trillion wife and concubine, with whom he never probably seen at all. But in the former life, is it possible that the king has many thousands of concubines? Yeah, you know that. You saw the history and you saw some film. Is it true like that? And maybe 2,000 eunuchs, yeah, and etc., etc. Yeah, a lot of soldiers, yeah? Yeah, okay. It's like nowadays, the nuns, Catholic nuns, they wear a ring, married to Jesus. Yeah. Jesus was a single. Yeah. Had no house, no wife, yeah? And walk barefoot, yeah. And then after he died, he has countless of wives. Isn't that something? Isn't that something? Yeah. Yes. Maybe this king is so morally fit, yeah, and very a virtuous king. I will see. I will see if he's good or not. It should be, yeah. That's why people revere him, you know what I mean? And just say, oh, I would never meet anyone as good as the king, so I vow to be his wife. From now on, I just worship him alone, you know? I don't care for anybody else like that. Doesn't mean maybe it's possible like that. Doesn't mean that the king ever asked him to go to the palace or something. Or maybe, why not? You know, take turn to come in and say hello and get out. Because he has one wife. The first wife is named Flower. Yeah. Some beautiful flower, something like that. And he has 10,000 ministers. Oh, that is credible. Nah? That's credible. And the biggest of them, I think is like prime minister, is his name is Great Moon, prime minister. He has 500 princes. I told you 500 is a number, yeah. And the first prince is Virtuous Longevity. Wow, what a good name. We all like that name, huh? I translate it, okay? The meaning is like that, okay. And his, how you say, the royal war, the royal palace war, is about 400 miles square. Phew. I say so. Probably the mice at that time is about this long, no? Yeah, good. And then it's all made with pure gold, diamond, a crystal, etc. Yeah. And four direction has 420 doors, gate, yeah. And all the street and road and all the city houses are very, very beautiful, neatly arranged and clean and very pleasant. My God. That is the time of, how you say, golden age, no? Yes. And this king probably has almost the power of the heavenly king. That's why, yeah. Nowadays, if a king has such walls and make with gold and diamond and crystal, etc., oh, that king will not be able to sleep at night. If his citizen don't come and dig them out and bring it home, the other country will. Other country's citizen or army will. Eh? Imagine 400 square miles full of gold and diamond and crystal. My God. Huh? Yeah. Yeah, my God. What a world to live in at that time, eh? And now we are paying fortune just for a little diamond like this. If somebody give somebody an engagement ring about the size of this diamond, oh, she will go all over the world and say, look, 4 carat, 3 carat, 5 carat, you know, pure diamond, you know. And whenever she eat or something, she would always put this hand up instead of using, if she's right-handed, she would try to use the fork with the left hand, yeah? And a chopstick with the left hand, so that everybody see how big the diamond is on the engagement ring. Yeah, I don't know if people do that. I saw that on TV. It's a big deal. If you have such a big diamond, you know? Oh no, your engagement ring, no? Yeah, in the West like that, no? All right. All right, okay. It's all the city inside, the houses and the roads are all absolutely amazing and perfectly and neatly arranged and clean and very, it has such an awesome dignity, all of them. In that country, there were four rows, that's this silver. I don't know if it's made by silver or is already planted, like grow up like that as silver. And then others also, 4 rows with the gold, trees with gold, sounds like heaven, huh? And also with diamond trees, and then crystal trees, yeah. All the branches are gold or diamonds or silver. Yeah. Gold, diamond, silver, or crystal. And then many of the ponds and many of lakes inside that city is made by four kind of precious. Just like the one we described, eh? silver, gold, diamond, and crystal. Yeah, all of the all the rim of the ponds and the lake inside the sea, inside that countries are also surrounded by wall with all kind of these four kind of precious, and under the water, at the bottom of these lakes or these ponds, apart from have flowers on top, these are the sands. The sand there is also is a mixture of these four kind of precious above mentioned. Yeah, I'm lazy to keep saying. Yeah. Inside the palace of the king, there were 40 miles square, 40 square miles. It's also, all the palaces are made also with these four kind of precious substance, as I mentioned before. Yeah, at that time, the country is powerful. Yeah, the citizens are prosperous, happy, joyful, everybody contented. Okay, wow. No wonder they don't go and dig the king's walls and the palace to get the gold and diamond out of it. Because they're all prosperous and happy and rich, and the whole country is rich. I wonder where from. How can they get rich? They don't say why. Probably because it's a big country, and there's many smaller countries, so they probably exchange good and have a lot of work, Yeah, not like unemployed and stuff. One day, the king was sitting on his golden, and many precious stone thorn. Okay, and he was suddenly, it came to his mind. He was thinking like this: human, on this planet. If you are in a noble position, high position, revered by all people, and rich, and has all the things that you wish for, that is because in the former life you have done some good deeds or practiced some good method. Therefore, now you reap the reward. Yeah, he was thinking like that. It's like the farmers, in the springtime, he's diligently sowing many different seeds. Yeah. And then in summer and autumn, he will reap the harvest accordingly. Yes. So that he can sustain himself and then sustain many others. Yeah. If in the springtime he has not diligently worked on his field, then in summer and autumn he has nothing to harvest. Myself also, the king was thinking like that. In a former life, I must have been practicing charitable deeds, and doing good work. So nowadays I can reap this beautiful benefit. Yes. Now if I don't continue to practice in a good way, then in a future life I will have nothing. After I finish all this merit, enjoy all this privilege, in the next life, I will have nothing left then. After he was thinking thus, he asked all his officials, ministers, open all the royal store to take out all the money and gold or silver or whatever, and food, the storage of cereals, whatever they have there, give it to all people, to the citizens. And then he also ordered 84,000 smaller kings must also open their stores and donate it to the needy. Yeah. So all the smaller kings obey this great king, and then tell everybody to do that. So ask all the tell all the citizens. So whoever came have received what they wanted. The day of charity, wow, a lot of citizens came to the palace gate. So many, like a sea of people. The strong one carry the weaker one, yeah. The young one take care, you know. The older one holding on to the younger one. And the one who has eyes leading the blind, yeah. And everyone receive what they asked from the king. And everybody was happy with clothing and food. Yeah, I thought that was a prosperous country and nobody needed. I guess a majority, huh? Never any country has all the people have the same level of richness, right? Mostly not, even in that time. So, yeah, everybody was happy and praising the king sky high. Yeah. At that time, there was one small kingdom named Timaduna. Seeing all the citizens everywhere respected, you know, and praising the king Moonshine too much. Oh, he's so jealous. It's typical. He became very jealous. So jealous that daytime he cannot sleep, nighttime he cannot eat. On the contrary to you. Daytime you sleep, nighttime get up, go get something in the kitchen. No, I'm just joking. Not all of you like that, right? Normally no, right? Yeah, yeah. Daytime you eat, nighttime you eat again. It's not as I said, right? Okay. Oh, daytime you sleep, nighttime you sleep again. Apart from the eating time, no? So, this jealous king was thinking to himself, what can I do to wake you up? Huh? Some of you. It's okay. No, only Thomas, for example. And this. No, they've been out all day, you know? Yeah, some people have to be out all day doing job. Some has to go out do shopping, no? So when they come back, they're tired, no? No wonder he always hide behind there, you know? Today somebody dragged him, put him here, I don't know why. Because he's a Westerner. Oh, poor guy. Okay. Tomorrow you can continue to stay behind as usual. Eh? Yeah, because it's very terrible to keep go out all day, you know, and come home like tired. Eh? Yeah. Today I give them some of the special Vietnamese food. Don't be jealous, okay? Just to appreciate their sacrifice. Eh? I could have gone home, you know. But both of them, husband and wife, have been working here ever since you came. I mean, from SMC until now. Yeah. And we have to appreciate that, no? Yes. Mostly husband and wife, they like to snuggle with each other at home, no? Who would like to come here and work like that every day and sleep on this slanted slope with a technique? Even with a special technique. Who would like that? Huh? Technique, my foot. At home, you have big bed, no? Queen size, king size, or even on the floor when you meditate, you have carpet and it's level, it's even. It's not slanted with technique to sleep on. So I do appreciate them very much, yeah? Appreciate it. And Kong Te U Liang, okay? Yeah. Even if I don't appreciate it or I forget to thank you or I'm too busy to take care of special group like shopping group or driver group, please know that you are thanked by everybody. Yes. in their heart, yeah? And also you will get your reward, okay? Even if I'm so forgetful to thank you, all of you, all the workers, the kitchen teams who wake up so early every day, yeah? To prepare our delicious food for everybody, yeah? And the driver who drive no matter what time to go to the airport or bus station to get people, forgetting their comfort and their sleeping time or their meditation time. We do appreciate it very much, and heaven will take note. Do take note. Yeah? Don't worry. Your merit will not be forgotten. Yeah? And your... the Buddha knows. Okay. The Buddha, you know, right? You know, they're a good worker. They're okay, right? Okay, yeah. All right, thank you. Yeah. Don't forget them, huh? Even if I don't say so. You know, because sometimes they don't feel well also. You know, human body, yeah? Woman body, sometimes every month, one time, don't feel well or don't sleep well, and they still go out and do the job every day. No complaint. And no trying to go to the front for everybody know them, and no telling anybody what they're doing even, okay? So I really appreciate that. It's good for you. Good for you. Good for the people who does that. Yeah. But even then, we should be grateful, huh? Mm. You know, and his friends, you know, for example, him, huh? Been away for more than a month, and then often before that, when necessary, you know, must be missing cheese and stuff like that. Here we don't have, okay? Yeah. The friend, they like the camembert, you know? But then he became vegan, and then I don't see them make any camembert vegan yet. So I gave him some of the other cheese. Vegan cheese, yeah. But even then, you know, to sacrifice cheese is something great for a French person, understand? Whether vegan cheese or non-vegan cheese, this is something, yeah? And the baguette, you know? Oh. The baguette, the French people, they go out every day to the baguette shop, to the long bread, French bread we call baguette, get it fresh and eat it right there, even. On the way home, yum, 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 yum. Yeah, because they like it. It's their staple food, a national food. You see, just like you like rice or noodles, see what I mean? And here he eat like cold bread. When he come home, it's cold already and no cheese. My God, what a sacrifice, huh? So you should transfer this merit to a Buddhahood, no? Yeah, talking about this. The Buddha, the king, gave all his storage, food and clothing and whatever, you know, gold and silver in the store for his citizen in need, yeah. And I was saying to you, I thought this country is prosperous, you know, and rich, but it's not always everybody is rich, huh? Yeah. Now, when I was in Monaco, for example, it's supposed to be a very prosperous country, yeah, small country, and everybody is well off. It's not like they're too poor or there's no bag or nothing like that. It's just that somebody still have some extra need. You understand? Yeah. And so sometimes I chip in a little bit here and there, yeah. But because that country, you have no income tax, understand? So a lot of people also tax-free for many enterprise there. Therefore, the government probably don't have this kind of tax income to give some extra to citizen, yeah? So other organization, private, they're doing this, yeah. It's just an example, eh? But the Monaco people, they're well off. They're well, mostly very well, yeah. Okay. Right. And when I first go, the people say, I keep asking, I want to see the Monaco, you know? The Monagas, they call it Monagas. I want to see the real one, Monagas, what they look like. I was curious, and I said, is there any Monagas working here? Can you point to me? They said, no, the Monagas, they don't work. It's not true. Most of them, maybe, yeah, has money and don't work. But some are working there. I found some. Yeah. Very nice people also. Very nice. Very polite. Yeah. Very, I feel they're very simple in the heart. Very pure. Kind of, yeah. One of the waitress I saw in Monaco, she adopted one Vietnamese, a child. Yeah. It's so funny, huh? The world is small. And one of the Monegas, he drove a taxi. He's a taxi driver. But he has an apartment worth more than $1 million. I don't think he's a taxi driver. And then I sometimes have to rely on taxi, you know, over there. So I had a little apartment there. Whenever he come to me, he brings a special car. It's not a normal taxi. He brought his own car, the Mercedes, white and beautiful. And he said, "Just for you, princess." Very moving. Yeah, very nice. Yeah. Okay, where are we? Oh, we're going everywhere. To Monaco, even. Okay. So, oh, we go back to the king who was so jealous that in daytime he couldn't sleep, in nighttime he couldn't eat. Yeah. He was thinking to himself. Are you okay with you're tired? You okay? You?
Okay.
Your English okay?
Yeah, actually.
Cramp a little, huh?
Yeah.
Stretch it out. Ah, like this. Oh yeah, my also. God. We're all getting old, you know that. Yeah, massage a little bit. Because you Westerner have long legs. Just stretch it out, my God. Anybody, stretch it out. Stretch it out. I don't care. Put on top of the front person. Shoulder. Yeah, massage a little. Yeah, let's do some exercise. Oh, moving back and forth. Left and right. Okay. I asked you if I should read the rest tomorrow, and you say, no, you want it now. Huh? So we stop now?
No.
No? So we go out and... You know, left, right, front, back first, and then come back or not? Huh? Yeah, no, yes, no. Okay, do what I do. Yeah, and do this, you know, a little bit. Kick in the front, not the front people. Okay, yeah. Wow, I really am impressed by your patience. So you sit down there, you know, on your small cushion and, you know, long hours. Told you. I don't know how many more pages, okay? I'm warning you, I don't know how many more pages. Wow, it's a lot. One, two, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. And your master coming in between. And I had to wait for the break when you're laughing. Wait until you finish laughing to continue. So, are you okay or tomorrow?
We have
who's okay? Raise hand. So don't blame me then. This is not okay, not okay. Listen. Who are not okay can go out. I mean, no, I mean, really, really. This is a democracy here, you know, we don't force you. You came here all by yourself, you sat there all by yourself. No, nobody asked you to. All right, so let's see what this terrible king is scheming, you know? He is scheming something, up to no good. Okay, so he was thinking to himself, if, the jealous king was thinking to himself, if I don't use some strategy to destroy this king, you know, the moonlight king, then my reputation, my fame will never spread anywhere. Forever become a small, forever stay the small king, you know, obedient to the great emperor. Oh, this is terrible, terrible. No, cannot, he cannot bear it. So he summon all the Brahmin men from his country to his palace. He offer them 3 months. Beautiful food, clothing, all the best treatment. I treated them like the king of the country. And then, after 3 months of bribery, I guess, well, he has some, string attached. He's not offering out of respect or anything to the Brahmin caste or the Brahmin renunciate, but he has something. Okay, let's see what he wants. Now, this is very, very, how you say, suspend. Suspending now. So he said to them after three months long, dear, all the religious reverence, yeah, I have one thing which worry me very, very much day and night, that in the daytime I forgot to to eat, yeah, to sleep, to eat, and nighttime I forgot to sleep. Any of you has any idea, any way to help me to solve this problem or not? So one of the chiefs of the Brahmin group said, Your Majesty, whatever worry you, please tell us. Maybe we can help, we will try our best. Yeah. After eating so much, drinking so much, sleeping in good bed, and having new clothes, of course, no? You die for the king, no? Sure, they should know. So the king say, hey, yo, all your reverence. Nowadays, the king, Moonlight, is respected and even revered like God by everybody in every country. No, of course, that poses the risk for me in the future. Yeah. Do you, any of you, has any magic power or any way to destroy him? Please tell me. So the chief of the Brahmin say again, Your Majesty, the king Moonlight has great merit. He is a great person, and he loves citizens as his own, as if his own children. And all the citizens look up to him as if he is their father. So how would we even have the heart to even harm him in any way? We rather die, but we would have no heart to harm such a wonderful and a gentle person, gentle being. Yeah. And then everybody bowed down to the king and asked permission to leave. Oh, he was so mad. He's more mad now. More jealous, more mad. He's so angry. His face looked like a tiger. Yeah. And then he ordered, he put notice, announcement to everybody in his country, saying, if anyone can go and get the head of the king, Moonlight, then I will marry that person to my princess, to my daughter. And then I will divide this country into two parts and give him half of it. Wow. Become prince and has half of the country. Wow. He must have been very, very jealous. There was a person also from Brahmin clan came to the king, the jealous king, and say he will go and get the head of the Moonlight King. Oh, this king now smiling for the first time. So, oh, if you can do this, I will keep my promise. When are you going? Tell me. He say, okay, in 7 more days. 7 more days. And then he left. When he came home, he entered a retreat for 7 days. Oh, what a retreat. Garbage. Rubbish. Retreat. People do retreat to improve their spiritual status and spirit. This guy, he entered a retreat to be more powerful, to kill. And he 7 days long, he concentrated on reciting a special mantra to protect himself. Yeah. After 7 days, he went to the king and said he's ready to go. The king gave him food and money and clothing and whatever necessary. Yeah. And he was very determined. And he said to this jealous king, he said, "Your Majesty, no more worry. I vow to you, or I swear to you." No, he make a vow, make an oath, yeah? How do you say that? I swear to you? I swear to you that if I don't get the head of the Moonlight King, I will not return. I guarantee it will be done. Oh. And then he begin his journey. At that time, immediately when he said that, after he said that, and began his journey, in the country of the Moonlight King appear many unlucky omen, omen, like earthquake, thunder in wrong season, yeah, a blitz, no, lightning, you know, in the wrong time, wrong place, anytime, and many of the stars keep falling, yeah. And daytime, a lot of fogs and something like in England, you know,
mist.
No, they say something else.
Fog.
No, maybe fog. You know, this is. Cover the whole street and all that, people don't see each other.
Mm.
Smoke, no? No. No, they don't have car at that time. No smoke. Fog, huh? Fog. Cover all day. And then they have comet also. And then even rain down ice. Yeah. They call it, what is it? What
hail.
Is it?
Hail.
Huh?
Hail.
Hailstone. Yeah, hailstone. And everywhere is a lot of thunder and lightning, yeah. And then many birds are crying in the sky, very, very heartbreakingly. And then they are plucking their own feathers and then just fall off the ground and die all over, you know. All over the earth like that, yeah. And then the tiger, a leopard, and a wolf, and etc. Yeah, they just jumped into ditches and die, or crying, lamenting. Very, very, very heartbreakingly. All other kings, smaller kings, yeah, are dreaming that the king's canopy, golden canopy, is broken. Yeah, and the golden drum also broken. Yeah, they dream like that. All of the smaller kings dream like that. And then Dainik is not the king. They write it wrong. Oh, his prime minister, Great Moon, dreamed that the demons came and snatched away the king's golden crown. Oh. Everybody saw all these bad omens and bad dreams. They were so worry so much. At that time, there was a guard who guard the god, you know, smaller god, yeah, a spirit, a deva, who guard the city, the palace, knew that this Brahman named Daulosai is coming to ask for the king's head. So when he saw this Daulosai, the Brahman came near the city gate, he used his power to confuse him, make him going around, he could not find the gate to come in. Yeah. But one of the God in heaven, oh God, again, he saw that. He interfered all the time, this God. So he entered into the king's sleep as a dream and told the king that, your majesty, is doing charitable deed, but there is one person who came to ask for your charity, and he's running around outside your city wall, cannot get in. So the king woke up and feel surprised. So asked his prime minister, come in. You go out in the palace gate, and forbid anybody to stop anyone who come in to beg in for charity. Okay. So the prime minister, a great moon came out. Went out to the palace gate. Look around, don't see anybody. Yeah. And no, doesn't see anybody who stop anybody even. Yeah. So the god, the deva, a spirit that protect the palace, appear in a physical body. Tell the prime minister. Dear Prime Minister, this time, now, at the moment, there is a Brahmin person from another country came here. I want to ask for the king's head as a charity. Therefore, I try to stop him. That's me. So the Prime Minister said, oh my God, if it's true like that, then it is a terrible, terrible disaster. But because the king already ordered us, we should not disobey him. All right. So the god release this Brahman and let him come inside the palace gate. The prime minister, great moon, was thinking to himself, oh, if this person wants the king's head, then I'm going to make 500 head, which is done by seven jewels, precious jewels. Okay, so he went out and ordered many of the craftsmen, jewelry men, to make the 500 head full of, full with seven kind of precious stones. At that time, this Brahman suddenly like wake up from a dream. Yeah, and then he went inside the gate, not confused anymore. So he came in and very loudly talking like he owned the palace, you know, very rude, saying, I came from far away. He didn't say your majesty or, you know, anything. I came here from far away. I came from far away here because I know you, the king, is exercising your charitable deed. Anyone who asks anything from you, I came here to ask also something. But this is a very difficult thing I ask. So the king saw that this person is a kind of so, you know, rude. And he was thinking to himself, this person probably want to test me. Yeah. So he was kind of happy, you know, glad. And he himself, the king himself, came out, yeah, and greet him and ask him politely where he came from and how is his journey, is he very tired, does he need any, you know, thing to eat, to drink now? And then he asked, what is it that you request? Please tell me, however difficult if I can, I would offer it to you. So Lao Doshai, the Brahmin, said, all the things that you gave in charity, maybe money, food, clothing, medicine, or anything at all, that will bring you merit greatly, no doubt. But that's this merit is nothing compared to the merit that derived from you when you derive from when you compare nothing, no merit. This merit is nothing compared to the merit that you give something from your own body. Yeah, understand? Yeah. So I don't want anything else. I just want your head. If okay, you tell me. Just like that. It sounds like a modern time, huh? If okay, you tell me. What now? Right? Okay or not? So the king say, seriously, solemnly, yes, I'm very pleased and sincerely offer my head to you. So the Brahmin asks, now or when? You know. So he say, please, great reverence, give me 7 days. Yeah. Give me 7 days. After 7 days, I will give my head to you. Yeah. At that time, at that moment, the prime minister, a great moon, brought in 500, a jewel crafted human head, looked like human head, and come in and beat his hand into his chest and said to the Brahmin, ah, the king's head is only made with flesh and blood. It's nothing good, you know. It will stink and it's not nothing really valuable. Yeah, it's not clean. Yeah, after you chop it off, it will smell badly. So I give you 500 jewel heads here. Hey, if you brought it back to your country, you will live all your life and your family in luxury. Oh, the Brahmin say, sir, I don't need these 7 jewels head. I just want the king's head. I came here just for that. Oh. The prime minister saw that this person is too stubborn and so wicked like that. So he couldn't even do anything more. So he toned down his voice and he begged him to change his mind and take the 500 jewel head instead. And talk in such a sweet voice, gentle voice, humble voice, and gentle voice. And he lowered himself. Yeah, but this Brahmin Lao Doshai insisted on his request of the king's head. So the prime minister, so frustrated and angry, he died immediately from heart attack. He died immediately in front of the king, to him. Oh, at that time, the king and all the court officials felt so sorry. Terrible. Everybody cried and cried. King and officials, they all cried. So, and they arranged to bury him. After the burial, the king and others, court officials, oh, no, he ordered all the officials go all over the country, tell everybody that all the citizens, you should know, the king moonlight because he is very deep in his spirit of charity. And from before, he has given all the citizens in need all the things they need, you know, food, clothing, and money, etc. But now there is a Brahmin named Lao Doshai. He came from another country, come here to ask the king for his head. And the king has decided to give it to him so that his great vow will be realized. Yeah. He vowed to give anything except his parents, you know? Yeah. Even his wife or his country, anything he'll give. So if any citizen want to come that day, 7 days from today, to say goodbye to the king or to witness his charitable deed, then you can come. Oh, after hearing such news, the whole country in mourning. 84,000 smaller king. They also, you know, very troubled. So they all gather to the palace of the king, and they all kneel down and tell the king thus, "Your great majesty." Yeah. The whole planet, yeah, the whole world is relying on your grace and your blessing and your merit and your great virtue to be happy and contented and have peace. Therefore, we normally have a good harvest, yeah, smooth wind and good weather, you know, no climate change. Yeah, no climate change. Yeah, everybody happy and fulfilled. Yeah, feel happy and content. Yeah. How come? Why? Just for one person, you were sacrificed like that without concerning about all of us. He just can feel obliged, you know, responsible for all the citizens in the whole world instead of just one person. At that time, he ruled the whole world, I guess. Yeah, there's like a one world country then, huh? Mm. So 10,000 great ministers in one voice, unanimously told the king, "Please stop this offering of your head. We have never heard of this kind of ridiculous request ever since, ever." You know? Yeah. Now you are listening to one of this a wrecked person. Yeah, a crazy person. And it's such a crazy and a stupid person. Let us feel very confused and, you know, trouble. Don't listen to him. Yeah. And then 2 billion or million wives and concubines and 500 princes all came. And they all, fell down on the ground and crying, lamenting and begging him to stop this. But the king was very calm, composed, still, and comforted them, saying, "All of the kings and queens and princes, please calm down and listen to me. Human beings, since times immemorial, because of love and sensual attachment, always have to transmigrate in the life and death circle forever. Yeah. Nobody, it's very difficult to find someone. In this sentence, he said that we haven't seen anyone who could detach himself, from the love of their own body yet, up to now. Yeah. I observed that since countless of aeons up to now, I die and live and relive and reborn and die again and again and again, how many lives I could not even remember or count. And even sometime in hell, when someone is in hell, every day he die many times. Yeah, it's made like that. They make you die, and then you live again, and die and live again, so that you suffer. And then even die in the septic tank kind of liquid. Yeah, or die in the die on the burning bed, or die tied up into the burning pole, burning brass pole, or in the excrement liquid, boiling liquid, or sitting on the wheel, burning wheel, or laying on the burning coal ditch, etc., etc. Yeah, or come in and out of many different hells. How much suffering, how much pain, you could not even describe and remember. Yeah. And to count all these bodies that has been wasted, thus, has not helped anyone by dying and living and dying in all kind of since times immemorial. This kind of body has never helped anyone and never earned any merit at all. Just wasted. Yeah. And even when you are degraded into animal's body, and then other people kill you, chop you off and eat you, and then even all that body is also wasted without earning any merit at all. Yeah. And he described that sometimes we... God, excuse me. Is there anybody has some medicine for me later? Do we have any medicine for runny nose? Have or not have? Yeah. Better than nothing. Yeah, please. Yeah, so that I can continue my job. I don't want to keep disturbing you, blowing nose and stuff like that. Even if you have not been in hell or became animals like that, you could have been, anyone, him even, could have been born as hungry ghost. Or some beings that always been burned with fire or from inside the body. The fire come out, or the some beings that the knife keep always coming and chop his head off forever. It's kind of punishment. It's not in hell, but it's happening in some other level of consciousness. And these bodies are so many to count, and it's nothing helpful to your spiritual improvement. Something wrong? Mosquitoes?
Yeah.
Oh, we have mosquito? No, mosquito, bad mosquito. You want mosquito medicine?
I'm okay.
I don't have. Sorry, but I can give you a swing gum. Yeah, what is that? Bring here. Yeah, here. It's cooling. It's mint. It's my cool. No, you have to put with your wet it first. It cool in a little bit, no? I don't have anything here. Sorry about that. What is? Nose?
Yo, jiang yo.
Is this jiang yo? Okay, put in your nose. Thank you, anyway. Enough, I mean, symbolic. Even the whole bottle cannot erase the karma. I just, for love at least, no? I feel comforted a little bit, yeah. Like somebody cares, you know? Okay. Married, Gong Tao Liang, no? Yeah, give medicine to the sick, no? Yeah. One of the five top meritorious charitable deed, no? Yeah, remember? There were five kind of topmost meritorious deeds, yeah? Giving necessity, you know, offering necessity to the people who came from far away, or the people who going away far, and giving medicine to the sick people. What else?
To the neediest.
Huh?
To
the most need people.
Huh?
Giving the thing to people who need it the most.
Okay, give it to the needy. What else?
Giving the teaching of the Buddha.
Giving the teaching of the Buddha to the one who wants it. Yeah, not to go and just give it to anybody, huh? Yeah, like give initiation to whoever wants it, huh? Sorry, guys. I don't know why today I look like that. Normally I look very good, right? You know, right? Oh, must be the Shaka God again. Try to test me something. He thinks I will care for my good luck, good look, and then I don't come out today. You're wrong. Yeah. Okay, I continue. For example, now he meaning he keep listing here all the wasteful time that your body has been used, you know, and it's not for sacrifice, it's not offering, nothing. Just die and live and die and live. And it's a waste of life. Yes, that's what he meant. So, and now, my body, he said, it is nothing much but the filth inside, you know, blood and pus and, you know, runny nose, for example, yeah? And nobody even want to look at it, yeah? If we open it, it's nothing but filth and impure things, yeah. One day, this body also will become rotten, like everyone else, like all other beings, yeah. And now, if I just forsake this filthy head of a human, flesh and bones and no kind in it, yeah. To in exchange to the Dharma body, yeah, the forever lasting body, yeah. And forever you'll be happy and bliss. What is that?
小青龙汤。怎么？这。叫他，然后再喝点开水。帮什么忙呢？
那个清水鼻涕咳嗽，没有，OK，不是吧？ Oh my God, this is typical Chinese medicine. Oh God, they make you drink a lot. Yeah, I remember one time I was sick, you know. A Chinese doctor prescribed many medicine, and I have to drink one bowl after another, different medicine. not like Western medicine, you take a couple of pills here, or maybe even just a handful of pills, a different sickness. It's still just a handful of pills, easy to swallow. But Chinese medicine, no. They give you a big bowl, you know. This medicine and another bowl for that medicine, and you have to eat after or drink after. And oh my God, I say, how can my stomach even eat anything more or drink anything more after all these bowls? You know, big bowls of a liquid. So this is very humane already. Please, I can't. This is just to rinse bitterness, he said. Just try to stop me, huh? Yesterday, last night I was okay, right?
Yeah.
No sign of sickness, nothing. It just came like that. Just this evening. Not like the whole day or nothing. tried. He even say that when you are in a human's body, sometimes because of greed, yeah, and lust and desires, even killing each other. You know, we can see it nowadays still, right? So all this body has been dead and alive again forever, forever. It's useless, yeah? So today he just sacrificed one of the filthy part of the body in order to exchange for a Buddhahood in the future, you know, like wisdom and a spiritual improvement, yeah, enlightenment. Then it's really good thing to do. Mm. Even just not only me will benefit from this, but all of you will benefit as well in the future. Mm? You mean when he became Buddha? Huh? He will save all of them. Yeah. So you should see further into the future. Yeah. And your vision should be grander. Yeah. Mm. You should not just concentrate on such a small, tiny little, object called body. Yeah. This is, if I sacrifice just a little thing from this lowly and filthy composite of the thing called body, in order to have such a great benefit for myself and for everyone, this is such a great thing. Why are you trying to stop me? Mm. When I offer this head to wish to become a Buddha in the future. And when I became Buddha, I will save all of you. Yeah, so that you can be liberated from life and death and suffering forever, forever. And you will be liberated forever and live in happiness and bliss forever. Mm. Why are you trying to stop my noble intention? Everybody heard the Buddha lecturing them thus. They all keep quiet. Don't dare say anything anymore. Okay, after the king saw that everyone quiet down, might not be calm down, but quiet down. Yeah. And he asked, he talked to Lao Doshai, the Brahmin. Okay, now you can cut my head. Lao Doshai say, oh, I am the only one here. I'm a lonely person here. I don't have any power, nothing to protect me. Surrounding the king is all your people, and even citizens and armies and guards and all that. If you really want to offer your head to me, please go to a very quiet, you know, secluded area where nobody see us. Mm. Then I would dare to cut your head. So the king announced to everybody, if you all say you love me, please don't harm Lao Doshai, the Brahmin. And then so he and the Brahmin went to the backyard. Mm-hmm. The back of the royal garden. And Lao Doshai said, the king, you know, you, the king, is very strong and robust, musculous. And if I cut your head, during cutting the head, maybe you feel pain and then you probably regret and then you might harm me, or you might run away. What to do? So you have to hang yourself from the neck, hang yourself to the tree branch, so it's easier for me to cut them. What a guy. So the king sat under the very big tree, used his hair to tie it to the tree, and say, okay, you cut my head now and put it on my hand so that I can respectfully offer it to you. After that, he make a vow, you see, obeisance to all the three direction and ten direction and the three times of the saints and sages. I sincerely offer my head so that I use this merit to request Buddhahood in the future. I do not want to use this merit to be any of the God in the heaven, any however high God in the heaven. So that I will not so to enjoy just in the three world, you know, three world. Yeah? Astral, causal, and the Brahma world. Yeah. I just want to become Buddha so that in the future, when I attain the Buddhahood, I can deliver other beings from suffering. That's all I want. Yeah. And then Lao Doshai would just raise his knife, wanting to cut the king's head. Then there was the spirit of the tree, the god of the tree. He used his finger to point at the head of that Lao Doshai, the Brahmin. And his hand became so weak, he dropped the knife, he couldn't do anything. You know, like a noodle, spaghetti in boiling water. Oh, cannot move. Yeah. And he even, you know, like turning around, you know, on the ground. Collapse. And then the king looked up into the tree and talked to the tree god, say, "Tree god, you should know, since time immemorial, in this spot, on this spot, under this tree, I have already offered 999 heads, same spot, same. Today I offer one more, then is 1,000. Then my offering is complete. Today, please don't make it complicated. Don't obstruct my charitable vow. Okay? Okay, so the god of the tree, okay, release the guy. So don't spin him around on the ground anymore, invisibly, but the king saw it. After that, Lao Doshai stood up and just one swing of his knife chopped the king's head off and put it in the king's hand. And the king still consciously offered it with all his respect. It's like when you give to somebody, you know, you do it with love and respect. That's what he did. Okay. At this moment, many heavens and earth all tremble. All the palace in the heaven are shaking, yeah, swaying here and there. All the gods in heaven and the heavenly beings was so stolid. Yeah. So they don't even know what's going on. What kind of God? No wonder sometimes we pray, they don't hear us. Such a thing like that, I don't know. So they were surprised and they all looked down. And then they know that one saintly being sacrificed his head for the sake of all beings. So they were also very, very moved. They all flowed down from heaven, crying like rain. But they are praising him also. They say, Bodhisattva, I mean saintly being. You, sir, doing this kind of extraordinary deed, no one would have dared to do as you did. Numerous beings, we all respect and impressed by you because of your unconditional love. The Jealous King. The Jealous King, Timatuna, after he heard that the Lao Doshai, the Brahman, has already got the head of the king, Moonlight, he was so overjoyed that he has a high blood pressure and heart attack, die immediately. Such is a waste. Lao Doshai carried the head of the king going back to the country, to the, you know, Jealous King country. All the officials, the governments, the workers, and the people, you know, anybody, and all the queens and, you know, ladies and prince, everybody saw that they all collapsed on the ground, crying and lamenting so much. Some even loved the king so much and so angry, so sad, so sorrowful that they also die of heart attack or vomiting blood. Some even just stood there as a statue, not knowing anything anymore. And the queens and other ladies, they pluck out their hair, and some, you know, tear their clothes. Some scratching their face, their body, until all bleeding, all crying and, you know, rolling on the ground with sorrow. Lao Doshai took the head of the king on the way back to that country, the Jealous King country. After a few days, it stinks terribly. It smells so bad. So he just threw it on the ground and walked on it. And then continue his walking. The citizens around saw that. They all yelled at him, scold him, and say that he has no heart, so wicked. If you cannot use it, why you went and ask for it? Everybody, you know, curse him and scold him and yell at him. And then they talk to each other. They forbid each other to give him any food, any drink, nothing. Yeah. And then he was so hungry and thirsty. Oh, hungry. Maybe water, he can get it from the river or something. But I was so hungry and walking very, very tiredly. And then he saw one of his acquaintance and he asked about the king, the Jealous King, Timatuna. They say, oh, he's too happy, so he died from heart attack. And Lao Doshai, the Brahman, heard that. He was so, hopeless, yeah? Helpless. He lost hope. So hungry and exhausted also, and he also died immediately in a heart attack. Mansion Kinder. Both of them, the Jealous King and the Brahman, both are went to the deepest hell, the non-stop torturing hell. And all the people who died because of loving the king, or sorrow, or feeling sorry for the king, they all went to heaven. Yeah. After saying this, the Buddha remind Anan, say, Anan, you should know, the king Moonlight at that time was one of my incarnation, past life. And the Timatuna, the Jealous King at that time, is the king of Maya this time. He went to ask him to die. That's the one. Yeah. Lao Doshai now is the Deodak. I don't know who is that. Whoever that is, we don't care. Yeah. And the spirit of the tree at that time Now is Mauda Lalayana, you know, the magical disciple, the magician disciple of the Buddha. The prime minister, great moon at that time, now is Sariputra. At that time, he cannot bear to see me die, so he died first. Yeah. Today is the same. He could not bear to see me gone, so he went first. That's all. I and all the and all that in the assembly, hearing the Buddha saying first, we had so much love for the Buddha, and we also moved by the sincerity and love from Sariputra, so loyal to the Buddha since many lifetimes. So we all praise his virtues and merit. Yeah. Everybody became inspired to be loyal, to be more loyal, more filial, and then so therefore they became purified. And so a lot of people attain a higher dimension, spiritual dimension. Yeah. Some even inspired to become Buddha in the future. Yeah. Everybody bow, you know, prostrate, and then went home. End the story. Wow. Are you glad, huh? Any comment, any question? About this story? Comment? Question? No? Huh? Yeah. Anybody want to become Buddha? No? I guess not. I also not. Okay. I guess I don't have to become Buddha, thank God, anymore. Okay, huh? I let you go to eat so the daytime you can sleep. There's still something in kitchen all the time, right? So anyone who feels still hungry, yeah, can calm your stomach. Yeah. Just don't eat too full, and then you sleep immediately. Just save it for the daytime. Yeah. Okay. I'm glad you are all here. And you are still here. Meaning you're still with me. And not how you say, distracted by outside temptation or different view outside or different gossip. That means you're strong, you're good. I'm glad for you. And I'm proud of you too. Okay? All right then. If no question, then Mama goes home. We'll see other kids. The dog, the four legs kids. Thank you, huh, for being so attentive and, you know, even though you're sleeping, you try to listen. Yeah. It happened. It's okay, giữ gìn cái gì được đâu, hồi nào nó đau thì nó đau, giữ được. Sức khỏe làm sao giữ được. She told me, try to keep your health. I said, how can you keep any health? Whenever you get sick, you know? Keep the health, even the health. How can you keep any health? I mean, this is life, you know? How you say? Birth, death, sickness. Old age. I have them all. Oh, not dead, not yet. Oh, I die every day when meditate. Sometimes, yeah? Okay, no problem, no problem. Just a little body trouble. Okay, body trouble is the least suffering. The least suffering, yeah. The suffering is more when it's inside, yeah? Mental, emotional, or psychological, you know? Other things. Body suffering is nothing. Very minimal. Okay, thanks for being attentive.
Thank you, Master.
Any new person came today?
No.
No? Oh, from yesterday?
Yes.
Good then. All right. Nobody was sitting here before?
Yes.
Yeah, they left just now?
Yes.
Okay, good. Good then. Ciao. Hey, did you see me?
Yes.
Today you make pencil. Today is not your day. Why you make pencil?
Because.
But thank you anyway. Yeah. Thank you. And share. Share with others.
Hey, the translation team can come up now. Have a look. Sorry to exile you to the back. What is all this here? Whoa. Cookies. Wow. Which one you like? Chocolate cookie? Or chocolate cookie?
Chocolate cookie.
Share, the three
thank
of you,
master.
Okay? Okay, don't have a lot, so cannot be one box each. Share.
Thank you.
Whoa. That's what I wanted. Share. Share it. Cough, runny nose. Medicine. Oh, you share together, no?
Yes.
Don't keep looking at me. They keep looking at my cookies. Share together, okay? With love. Share it, huh? With love, okay? Yeah. Share. Everybody, one only. Doesn't matter what, okay? One or half, depends, huh? I have not eaten yet. I will enjoy later.
Okay.
But I ate breakfast at 3 o'clock. Ciao.
Thank you for your love.
Now.